Hi, everyone, and welcome to tonight's program, Sabor de Cuba. I'm Yvonne Mendez. I'm the presenter of tonight's event. Some of you may know me from my work at UMass Amherst, working with music programs and community presentations. So I really want to thank everyone for being here. In 2014, I helped organize a trip to Cuba. And while we were there, we saw many really great musicians, including this really great jazz violinist, Julio Valdez Fuentes. So now that everyone's enjoying virtual concerts, I thought, why not invite him to perform? So I reached out to him, and of course he said yes. And so tonight I'm partnering with Hawks and Reed to present this event. The first of, I hope, a few collaborations with them for my new series I'm calling Valley Jazz Informances. And that's a spinoff of the program I helped build at UMass called Valley Jazz Network. Cuban music has been an integral part of jazz since Chico O'Farrill and Mario Bauza began playing with the likes of Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, Miles Davis, and John Coltrane in the 1950s and 60s. The mambo and the clave beats transformed jazz music. So tonight, we're presenting this virtual concert and live conversation with Julio Valdez Fuentes. So I want to welcome Julio. Bienvenido, Julio.
Bienvenido, Ivonne. Bienvenido.
Hola. ¿Cómo? Hey. ¿Cómo How estás? Are you? Oh, it's so good to see you. How are you?
I'm very happy. I'm very excited tonight to see you and to this going through and to play tonight.
I know you're very excited. I know we've met a couple of times and you and your family were just excited to present. And we're all really looking forward to your concert. You know, I was always so impressed with your energy and your musicianship. So I'm really, really glad that you're here and really excited to get you started with the concert. So I'm gonna let you go. We're gonna talk a little bit more with the audience and get you ready for the concert. So we'll see you in a few minutes.
Okay. So now tonight we play now.
Okay.
Music, and then we talk. Yes. See you. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Bali. Thank you, everybody. Okay. Ciao.
Ciao. Adios. So I wanted to have you more familiarized with Julio. He is a classically trained musician, born and raised in Havana, Cuba. He's an accomplished violinist, pianist, composer, arranger, and educator. He plays all these instruments. You'll see him bouncing around because, you know, when we saw him in Cuba, he's playing the piano, he's playing the violin, you know, he's singing. So, you know, multi-instrumentalist. He's ventured into the interpretation of the most universal genres of classical and popular music. His music is an eclectic and exciting combination of classical music, traditional jazz, Latin jazz, and Cubana rhythms. So we're all excited to have him perform. We're gonna start the concert in a few minutes, followed by a live conversation with Julio. So if you have questions you'd like for me to ask, please include them in the Facebook or the YouTube chat, and I'll try to get to them during the conversation after the concert. Also, please keep in mind that we're using sophisticated technology and we're streaming parts of this event live from Cuba. So I hope you'll be patient with us if we experience any technical difficulties. We're hoping not, but just in case, I want you to know that we're doing our best to make this a really enjoyable experience for you. So without further ado, I want you to enjoy the eclectic and joyful sounds of Julio Valdez Fuentes.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Estoy muy contento de que hayan asistido a este concierto online. Yo muy ansioso de poder compartir con ustedes mi música. Vamos a hacer un poco de música cubana, sobre todo. Casi siempre llevada al jazz, con el violín. Y bueno, esperamos pasar una noche sabrosa, ¿no? Aquí voy a empezar, mi nombre es Julio Valdez Fuentes y tengo el placer de invitarle a ustedes. Voy a introducir los miembros que me acompañan aquí hoy, que bueno, estoy muy afortunado que son familia, es mi familia muy querida. Y bueno, al sax y al piano el invitado especial, mi tío Jesús Fuentes. Aplauso, callaje. Bueno, al bajo, mi madre, excelente bajista, Giselda Fuentes. La band leader del grupo Canela de Cuba, Google that. Zoe Fuentes, mi tía. Y bueno, no por último, my little cousin, my sister, Melody Spartacus Fuentes. So we will start now with our first song. Is Ruffles. It's in my album I Feel Good, like you see that. And I hope you enjoy this new version. I Feel Good for you. Do you feel good? So I feel good.
Thank you.
Bueno, espero que estén disfrutando este concierto online. Yo me tomé el atrevimiento de hacerle un arreglo a un tema muy conocido de un gran compositor llamado Vittorio Monti. Entonces, yo quise traer a Vittorio Monti al Caribe y entonces vamos a hacer para ustedes Shardas de Vittorio Monti en el Caribe. Espero que les guste. Thank you. Wow, hace calor, ¿no? It's hot here in Havana. So, but now it's a pleasure for me introduce a master in the clarinet player, sax player, producer, excellent musicians. For you, Jesús Fuentes.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Ah, okay. 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 I would like to play something for you. I play one standard from one of the most important composers in the jazz, Mario Bauza. The name is Mambo Inn. Okay? Para ustedes, señores y señores, señoritas y señorones, Mambo Inn. Okay.
Thank you.
Bueno, this is a special moment, real, no? Clap your hand again. So, but the surprise is never ending here in my family. it's a musician's family. So now I will introduce my little sister, like I said in the beginning, Melody Spartacus, cantando quizás, quizás, quizás.
Hi, everybody. Really happy to be here with you tonight. And now we are going to have Julito on the piano. So this song is called Perhaps, Perhaps, Perhaps in English. And actually, it's quite known, so I hope you enjoy it. So for all of you, this is Quizás, Quizás, Quizás.
Siempre que te pregunto que cuándo, cómo y dónde, tú siempre me respondes, quizás, quizás, quizás. Y así pasan los días y yo desesperando y tú contestando.
Thanks so much, everybody. Thank you.
Entonces, so, again, clap your hand to Melody Spartacus, please. Ahora, now, I will like to introduce this song, it's from Django Reinhardt. The name is Minor Swing. But all we do in our version, Cuban version, for you, Minor Swing. Yo espero que ustedes estén pasando sabroso, rico, como yo, estamos guarachando ahí. Para ustedes, Manicero. Thank you. Como todo lo que empieza tiene que terminar y yo no quiero que termine, vamos a terminar con un tema también de DCD que you can find on Amazon, iTunes, I Feel Good, Julio Valdés. And now I will play the song that is in that CD, Atocha. This song was when I was studying in Madrid, in the Real Conservatorio Superior de Madrid. This conservatorio is in the place when is Atocha, which is like a big station train, which is communicated with all Spain, also going to France, and Portugal. So it's like a cosmopolitan city. When every morning I have to go to the study and I see Indian guy, African guy, people from North America, people from Asia, and everybody is with his culture. So I go in the train and I see people for different skin, different culture, and I say, I wanted to go to my school in my own way. You know, my way is here in Cuba. You know, Cuba is more slow city, and the train here is old, you know, very old, and going like, this name is Atocha, the song. Giselda Fuente. el final. It's hot, está caliente, está caliente, muy caliente aquí en La Habana. Pero el coro que yo quiero que ustedes en sus casas repitan conmigo, es fácil. Bailando en Atocha. Y si no, bailando en Atocha, yo quiero que ustedes canten de su casa. Bailando en Atocha, estamos guarachando, estamos gozando. Dice, bailando en Atocha, concierto online para que tú lo bailes. Bailando en Atocha, todo el mundo con la mano para arriba, todo el mundo con la mano para arriba. Bailando en Atocha, todo el mundo de pie, todo el mundo de pie. Dice, bailando en al timbal. Jesús Fuentes, Giselda Fuentes, Zoe Fuentes, Melody Spartacus Fuentes, my name is Julio Valdés Fuentes. Thank you very much. See you. See you.
It was better, the best thing I've seen in a long time. The music, that I was just dancing. I mean, it was just, I couldn't sit in my seat just quietly. It was just amazing. So what I wanna do now is I'd like to take a few minutes, give Julio a couple of minutes to join us for a conversation. So I hope you're all ready. If you have questions, make sure that you add them to the chat. Wherever you are, I know some folks are watching on YouTube, some folks are watching on Facebook, also the Vimeo link. I know there's people everywhere, but if you can get to the YouTube or the Facebook and write in your comments in the chat, that would be the best way to get your questions in tonight. So I just love Quizás, Quizás, Quizás. You know, Julio's band has a very beautiful way of changing things in a really exciting way. So I really enjoyed that one. I know there were folks who were writing Viva Cuba in the chat. Anyway, I want to talk a little bit about, I want to thank some people. do a little bit of credits before we switch over and invite Julio in. This event was produced by Yvonne Mendez, me, for Valley Jazz Informatives, and Ben Golcher and Stephen Golcher. I want to thank them very much from Hawks and Reed. With generous support from John and Pat Kandirsky, Ginger Goldsberry, Arlene Avakian, Sherry Taylor, and also Terry Lynn Carrington. I want to thank Joshua Fontanes. He is our interpreter for tonight for the conversation. Special thanks to Raquel Obregón, Kari Njiri, Eugene Uman, and the folks at Vermont Jazz Center, Paul Arcelanian, and all our other friends and colleagues who helped to spread the word about this event tonight. I also want to remind you that we are some of this is streaming live from Cuba. So if we have some technical difficulties, just be patient with us because, you know, we're dealing with some super technology here and doing the best that we can. I really want to thank Ben Volcher because he's the guy behind the scenes making sure everything connects together. So I have some questions I'm going to ask Julio. And if you have questions, again, please write it in the chat of the Facebook or the YouTube, and we'll try to get to them. So let me invite Julio. Bienvenido, Julio, enter.
Hi, everyone.
Hola, how are you? How are you? It's good to see
amazing.
You.
That is amazing, 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 amazing.
So for our audience.
Hot. It's hot. Yes. It's very hot here in Havana. Very, very hot.
Well, you know,
Muy caliente.
We're coming from New England, and it was actually snowing here earlier today. I think the high was 45. So this Caribbean girl, she doesn't like that. But, you know, that's where I live. It's New England. I want to introduce to the audience that with us is Joshua Fontanes. He is interpreting so that we can have a really smooth conversation here. Julio, I see you have your violin in your lap. Let me tell you. I was dancing, like it was just, I could not stand still. It was amazing, quite amazing that what you did. So thank you so much for such a great performance. Really wonderful.
Dijo que estuvo inquieta, no puedo quedarse quieta. Estuvo bailando todo el tiempo y te da gracias por una buenísima presentación.
Oh, muchas gracias y... Y yo estoy súper contento de que les haya gustado, ¿no? Porque esa es la idea. Realmente nosotros nos la hemos pasado aquí sabroso, sabroso, sabroso. Vaya, de verdad que sí. Sabor de Cuba, de verdad.
Yes. So I'm going to mix it up between my own questions and some questions coming in from the audience. Everybody loved it. So many great people wanted to be there with you. So the first question I have, which I'm curious about, but I think I know the answer. So are the musicians really your family members? Mary Rose asked that. She wanted to know if they were really your family members.
Alguien preguntó si los músicos verdaderamente son tu familia.
Sí, 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 sí. Mi madre, el bajo. Giselda Fuentes, mi mamá, mi tío Jesús, que es hermano de mi mamá, que es mi tío, que toca
el saxofón. My mom and my uncle, who is my mom's brother, was playing the piano.
Mi otra tía Zoe, que es la band leader de Canela Group de Cuba, Canela de Cuba, y mi prima Melody, estamos aquí de familia aquí, y mi abuela que está también sentadita por
and aquí. His aunt and his cousin, which was the young woman who sang, and his grandma who's sitting right in front of him. They were all family members who are part of the group.
Yo estoy muy contento, realmente. Yo estoy muy contento de hacer esta presentación. Es una experiencia muy bonita. Y lo más contento que estoy aquí, que estamos en familia corriendo. Ya muchos se tuvieron que ir rápido por la cuarentena que cierra a las 9. Mi madre se queda conmigo aquí, que nosotros nos quedamos cerca. Y estoy muy contento, muy contento, muy contento.
He's very, very happy to do this presentation. He said some of the band members had to run out because there's a curfew because of the quarantine. But he's there with his mom. And super happy about this presentation.
Well, I have a question about that. Someone asked if the band performs regularly in Havana.
Alguien preguntó si la banda regularmente se presenta en Havana hoy día.
No. Aquí hace más de un año de que no estamos trabajando en vivo, en directo, por el problema de la situación de la pandemia, ¿no? Del COVID. La música, todos los lugares, los clubs, los lugares, los teatros, todo está cerrado. Y normalmente no estamos ahora casi tocando en directo. Estamos trabajando más bien online.
Basically, for over a year, no one's been able to kind of do live presentations because of the quarantine, the pandemic. But everyone's kind of turning to doing kind of internet type of concerts.
So I'm going to flip back to one of my questions on the same line. I'm wondering, I know that we had a lot of back and forth with trying to figure out technology to make this happen. So I want to talk, I know that we talked about when the pandemic hit, you changed your thinking and switched right away to like, I want to do virtual presentations. So talk a little bit. I know you've actually had some really great collaborations because of that you wouldn't ordinarily have had outside of the pandemic. So talk a little bit about that.
¿Quieres que hable un poquito sobre? Ella dice que ustedes habían tenido conversaciones sobre esto un poquito, sobre la tecnología y todo esto, pero que desde que dio la pandemia, ¿cómo tú cambiaste el chip, como habías dicho anteriormente, de pensar de cómo seguir siendo creativo y que tuviste hasta colaboraciones que no hubieses tenido bajo otras circunstancias?
Sí, realmente desde marzo, el 15 de marzo, yo hice mi último concierto, el último concierto antes de la pandemia, ¿no? Y empezó esto de la cuarentena cerrada, el pánico mundial, tú miras todas las noticias y tú ves que el mundo entero en pánico. Pero yo, desde el mismo primer momento que empezó la pandemia, yo cambié el chip y empecé a buscar a todos los amigos míos, músicos y productores que he ido conociendo a través del mundo, cuando he estado en Estados Unidos, que he estado tres veces, cuatro veces en Estados Unidos, en Europa, en Madrid, en España, que viví, estudié, Eslovenia también, que trabajé, Croacia, en México, con un productor buenísimo. Entonces, he estado haciendo, he aprendido a lo que es mandar la música grabando en casa, mandando mi violín online por varias vías. Okay. Entonces, he tenido que aprender. Me mandan las pistas, yo las pongo, las mando. Hay veces hecho para violín, hay veces hecho dos violines, tres violines y producciones. Y okay, realmente...
Un momentito. So basically, he says that since March of last year, or over a year ago, was the last performance that he had live. So he says by seeing everything that was going on in the world, the pandemic, all the fear, all these things that were going on, he himself kind of did this like mental chip, like changing the way he thought, and kind of got inspiration that way and decided to kind of just reconnect with people he had lost touch with, producers, musicians all around the world, in Mexico, Spain, Madrid, Slovenia, and just started to exchange musical tracks. So, you know, he would get a track from someone and, you know, kind of learning that whole technology of kind of working in a new way.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So listen, so you touched a little bit on that about like having connections in other countries. Julio, talk a little bit about your touring experience before the pandemic.
Dice que has tocado un poquito sobre esto, sobre las conexiones que tienes en otros países con otros músicos y eso. Si puedes hablar un poquito sobre tus experiencias viajando y haciendo tour en el mundo antes de la pandemia.
Bueno, a mí personalmente, a mí me encanta viajar. Yo estoy viajando desde los 12 años a España y, y, y me gusta conectarme con las personas de locales. Yo llego a un país y voy a buscar a lo local, y me gusta tratar de integrarme a lo local. Casi siempre cuando he ido con tour y toda esa historia, yo tengo que tocar, por ejemplo, en un festival, y yo toco en el festival, pero antes de tocar el festival ya yo fui a un club de jazz, ya yo conocí a hago amigos, oye, mañana voy a tocar. Y eso me ha ayudado a que he ido conectando con muchas, tengo muchas amistades que chateamos, nos preguntamos, y bueno, vamos a dejarlo ahí para que
yo pueda llegar. So he says, personally, he loves to travel. Since he was 12 years old, he's been traveling. And he loves to connect with the people locally when he travels. He says, like, when he would travel to perform in a festival or something, he says, before a presentation, I already went to the local jazz clubs and kind of made friends with people and just kind of have people that I already connected with. And that's one of the best things about traveling, is being able to connect. And I've been able to maintain those relationships by chatting, texting, doing those kinds of, you know, keeping in touch that way with people.
Y entonces nos quedamos, casi siempre conozco una amistad con las redes sociales, por ejemplo, antes con mail, nos damos nuestros contactos, y casi siempre, por ejemplo, año nuevo, fechas importantes, oye, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Quizás, ¿cuándo nos vamos a volver a ver? Y entonces hay mucho impedimento, porque siempre es esperar un día a que vengan a Cuba o un día que yo vuelva a ir a tal ciudad. Por ejemplo, si yo conozco gente en Madison, yo fui una sola vez a Madison y yo tengo amistad en Madison. Entonces, más nunca he podido ver gente en Madison. Entonces, y tampoco pueden venir a Cuba. Y así me ha pasado con varios lugares que he ido, Surinam o muchos lugares que he ido un solo momento y nos quedamos test.
So in a lot of places that he's traveled, you know, he's run into this problem, because it's not always that he's able to go back and travel to that place, or people are able to come travel to Cuba to visit him. But he's always maintained those communications through, you know, social media, especially for special events like New Year's. They touch base and kind of just stay connected. Or any other important dates in people's lives. But he says, for example, he's traveled to Madison and has friends there, but you know, hasn't been able to go back and travel to a whole bunch of other places. But, you know, fortunately with social media and texting and email, stuff like that, the communications continue.
I have a musical question.
Ella tiene una pregunta música.
Yeah, I have a musical question.
Sobre lo mismo rápido. Por ejemplo, yo conocí a Ivonne, más muchos amigos más, en el 2014, cuando vinieron a Cuba. Bueno, desde el 2014, estamos en el 2021, hemos tratado de hacerlo y yo no he podido más. Esto estamos haciendo.
Okay, está bien, déjame hablar. So basically he said, on the same thread that you were just talking about, he said, for example, in 2014, I had the opportunity to meet Yvonne when Yvonne came to Cuba, and also met many other friends. And in the same way, you know, we're in the year 2021 now. So how many years have passed between then and now, and being able to stay in touch and build those connections through the internet was very good. And then he cut out and I didn't catch the rest.
Yes. Is he back? Julio, are you back?
¿Puedes escuchar, Julio? I think we may have lost.
Sí, escucho. Ustedes me escuchan bien.
He can hear. The camera's frozen, but he can hear. We can still talk.
Uh-oh, I think we might have lost him altogether.
We may have lost him altogether, yeah. Now.
But I want to ask him a question about music. We'll give him a few minutes to come back in.
Okay.
So my music question is this. You know, there's a rich history here in jazz with, you know, like you know, your uncle was talking about, you know, you played a song by Mario Bausa. And so there's this rich tradition of Latino music and jazz in the U.S. where Mario Bausa and Chucho Valdez and other musicians were working with American musicians like John Coltrane and Max Roach. And so I wanted, Julio, can you talk about your training and your learning? Like, who are some of the jazz musicians that have influenced you? Like your favorite musicians?
Ivonne está preguntando una pregunta. ¿Entendiste eso o quiere que te la traduzca?
Ok. Está bien.
Ok, so dice Ivonne que la pregunta tiene que ver con música y conociendo el historial de jazz en este país y también como tu tío había mencionado sobre la música de Mario Balzá y las colaboraciones que pasaron con muchos artistas latinos y artistas de jazz aquí en este país, como Chucho Valdés, Max Roach, y también si podrías hablar un poquito sobre tu entrenación en jazz cuando fuiste aprendiendo de todo eso.
Yo empecé a aprender el jazz gracias a mi tío, ¿no? Jesús Fuentes, que estaba aquí, de que yo desde muy niño, él tenía muchos recordes, ¿no? Aquí tiene un recording de Chucho Valdés, Paquito Rivera,
okay.
Es muy antiguo, y yo escuchaba mucho, todos estos discos, y después CD Compact, y empecé a escuchar la música,
okay.
Tratar de llevarla al momento, ¿no?
Escuché
a Miles Davis, John Coltrane.
So basically he was saying that a lot of his jazz kind of influence came from his uncle Jesus Fuentes, who played with him this evening, who has been involved in jazz music for a long, long time. And his uncle would play music albums and that he would listen to as a child. And he actually picked up one of the albums and showed it to us. And then later compact disc came out, his kind of learning about music continued. And again, there was like another cutout where the interpreter couldn't hear that part.
El reto más grande que yo he tenido que superar en mi vida es de que yo escuchaba mucha música como Mario Bauzá, como Chucho Valdés, Iraquere, Paquito de Rivera, Miles Davis, John Coltrane, Charlie Parker, Mike Breger. Yo escuchaba Chick Corea, Herbie Hancock. Yo escuchaba toda esa música. Pero no hay violín. No hay violín en esa música. Y okay. Entonces, hasta que una vez me regaló un amigo de mi padre, que es Lionel, me regaló un disco de Stefan Grappa. Y eso, yo tenía 12 años, cuando eso ya yo escuchaba desde niño, pero yo decía, ¿cómo hago? Todo es sax, piano,
okay,
drums, bass. ¿Cómo hago? No tengo lugar.
So there was un momentito.
Me regalaron
el disco que te regalaron a los 12 años, ¿cómo se llamaba?
Entonces, el disco que a los 12 años me regalaron un disco de Stefan Grappelli. Y ese fue okay. ese día mis ojos
okay.
se abrieron.
So dame un chance. So he says his biggest challenge with jazz was, you know, in the beginning always was because he would hear all these instruments that were played with jazz. And he would hear Mario Bassa, Chucho Valdez, Miles Davis, Chick Corea, all these artists playing their music, their jazz, and his love and fascination for the music. But he never could figure out how with a violin to do jazz. But it wasn't until he was about 12 years old when he was gifted an album or a disc from a friend of his father's of an artist named Stephen.
band that's all strings, and they're playing just jazz, strings, piano, and drums. And so that's a new sound. It's a very different sound. So I understand what you're saying. Like, you know, it's hard to jump into jazz when the big musicians that you see are the saxophonists and the trumpeters, and every now and then a drummer, you know? So I see, you know, that's why I asked you that question, because I know it's a difficult like place to enter.
Dice que ella puede entender lo que estás diciendo, que es un reto grande, porque ella trabaja con muchos músicos por acá y eso es una de las cosas que uno no ve, apenas ve, que el jazz utilizando instrumentos de hilo para producir ese sonido. O sea que eso es algo que ella estaba pensando y te quería hacer esa pregunta específicamente porque es algo que ella reconoce que no es muy común y no se ve mucho con los artistas grandes que tocan jazz.
No, y después que conocí a Stephan Grappelli, que casi tengo la colección entera de toda su música, porque yo sigo escuchando, después indagué también en la música de los Estados Unidos. Hay un violinista americano que se llama Stuff Smith, que también es muy, muy bueno, también antiguo. Y después vienen los franceses, Jean-Luc Ponty, Didier Lockwood, y bueno, y la música también, hay muchos violinistas cubanos, también como Lázaro Alberto González, hay otro, mira, que yo, amigo mío, Ismar Alderete, y muchos más para ir hablando. So, he ido aprendiendo.
So basically he was saying that, you know, once he discovered Stephan Grappelli, the artist you mentioned earlier, he pretty much went through all his music and kind of devoured it, and then slowly continued to add more to his palette and in getting other influenced by other artists. Like there's an American artist, a violinist, Smith, Stuff Smith, that he mentioned. And he says there's so many artists that he got inspired from, a French artist who play violin as well. He mentioned the French artist, but the interpreter could not pronounce the French names. He also mentioned that he received a lot of inspiration from Cuban violinists as well.
Can he talk a little bit about the Institute? Julio, talk a little bit about the Institute. Did you go to the Institute of Music in Cuba?
Si puedes hablar un poquito sobre el Instituto, que si fuiste al Instituto de Música en Cuba.
Es una belleza, es una belleza. La comunidad cubana de los músicos es una belleza porque nosotros nos llega muy poca información de música, porque y entonces casi siempre el disco de música de cualquier artista que tiene uno es el disco que tenemos todos. Y entonces tenemos por ejemplo, si yo tengo, oye, yo tengo el disco último de Yellow Jackets, o tengo el último disco de whatever, ese disco ya es obligación mío de pasárselo a todos mis amigos, porque entonces todos nos nutrimos de eso, de escuchar, y es una comunidad donde todos nos nutrimos de todos. Los okay. maestros somos nosotros mismos, porque aunque ustedes no lo crean, Cuba no tiene academia de música popular. Es una cosa que no se entiende, porque no existe academia de música popular. Toda la academia realmente cubana es de música clásica, y entonces la música de Cuba es la música popular. Así que desde muchos años.
So he was saying that basically the Cuban musical community is a really beautiful community because of the sharing that goes on within the artists. He says, like, for example, if there is one album from a certain artist that someone has, everybody shares that same album. So it's like if I have an album by Yellow Jackets, everyone that I know we is going to listen to that album, because I want everyone to get nurtured by that same music. And likewise, everyone, if they have something, they share it with each other. So it's kind of like they will milk that until they can. And he says, what's really interesting is that Cuba doesn't have any institutes of popular music. All the music that Cuba really puts out there is the classical. The classical music is what's really valued. And yet the strongest music that people love is the popular music of Cuba.
When he says popular music of Cuba, is that classical music? What is the popular music? Is it you know, rhythm and beats? You know what I'm saying? What is the classical music of
Cuba? Ella está preguntando sobre cuando tú dices música popular de Cuba, ¿te refieres a música clásica o estás hablando como que de música más de ritmo y quieres saber la distinción?
La música cubana es el son. La música cubana es el guaguancó. La música cubana es el changüí, la salsa, la timba, el danzón, el cha-cha-cha, el mambo. La música cubana es eso. Es eso la música cubana, la contradanza. So basically, no se da clase.
He's saying that the real music of Cuba between us is all that music that is not valued or studied, because all the music that is Cuban music, like el son, the guaguancó, salsa, la timba, el danzón, the cha-cha-cha, the mambo, all that is what people know as Cuban music, but yet it's not music that's taught in Cuba. People learn it because it's in them and they share it with each other.
So do you integrate those, like local musics into your jazz? Because you said you love, there are jazz musicians that you listen to. You're listening to Miles Davis, you're listening to Paquito and to Max Roach, Miles Davis, you mentioned a couple of times. So it's clear that you integrate that popular music into your jazz music.
Ella está preguntando si tú integras la música popular cubana. Porque has mencionado música local en tu jazz. Por ejemplo, has mencionado a Paquito, Miles Davis, Max Roach. Si integras esa música en tu jazz.
Sí, no sé si entendí bien la pregunta, pero sí tiene que ver mucho el jazz cubano. El jazz cubano es, viene siendo por Chano Pozo, que fue a Estados Unidos, a Nueva York, y empezó a tocar con Dizzy Gillespie, con Charlie Parker, empezaron a hacer cosas, Chano Pozo. Mario Bauzá, que es un gran orquestador cubano, cubano de que fue a los Estados Unidos y llevó, ellos son los iniciadores del cubop, que era el bebop, le hicieron el cubop, que era introduciendo las congas y dándole con los ritmos latinos. Ellos son los precursores del jazz cubano. Después viene una generación, bueno, dejamos ahí intérprete yo.
Okay, so gracias. So he says, I'm not sure if I understood the question, but basically he is influenced by Cuban jazz. For example, Chano Pozo was one of the first who went to the U.S. and played with Dizzy Gillespie. And also, of course, Mario Bauzá, one of the big ones. And then he says that they were also integrated music, Cuban music, into the jazz scene, which from bebop became known as cubop, for example. So yeah, some of those big jazz Cuban artists were influenced by American jazz artists and vice versa.
Yes, absolutely. Very good. Yeah, luego, I love that.
Y luego viene un grupo de experimentación sonora, una banda que se hicieron donde estaba Chucho Valdés, Paquito Rivera, no sé, hay muchas bandas que empezaron a hacerse que fue lo que hace de que Chucho Valdés hace luego los Iraqueres, que es el grupo donde están los grandes como Arturo Sandoval, Paquito de Rivera, Chucho Valdés, Enrique Placa, los del Puerto, hicieron ese disco Misa Negra famoso que ganaron el Grammy americano, American Award Grammy, y ese es el jazz cubano en su máxima expresión, donde llegó al pico. A partir de...
So he went on to say that then later other artists on top of, you know, from when he was talking before of like the artists that went to New York and worked with Dizzy Gillespie and so forth, like Chucho Valdez, Paquito Rivera, Iraqueres, these are great big artists who then later he mentioned that it kind of like crescendoed into some of those artists getting like the Grammy for their music, and then there was a little bit of cut out and the interpreter didn't hear that other part.
Yeah, Chico Corea just got Chick Corea just got a Grammy last year, which was really, really wonderful. And so, yeah, I think that there are a lot of strides that have been made in recognizing the intersection of Latin jazz and, you know, and regular jazz. So I know we're getting to the very end here right now, and I'm still waiting to see if there are any other questions, but I do have two like final questions. I know, you know, when we came down in 2014, it was to attend the Havana Jazz Festival. And so I'm sure that did not happen last year during the pandemic. But Julio, do you know if they're going to have the Havana Jazz Festival and if you'll be involved with that?
Estaba diciendo que sí, que el año pasado Chick Corea recibió el Grammy, le dieron el Grammy, y que él y otros son responsables para esa intersección entre el jazz americano y el jazz latino y trayéndole más reconocimiento a esa música. Y pero que dice que te quería hacer dos preguntas finales, y parece que no has recibido otras preguntas por el chat, pero lo que quería decir es que en el año 2014 ellos fueron allá a ver el Havana Jazz Festival. Y ella sabe que por lo de la pandemia, tal vez no se dio el año pasado. Y pregunta si crees...
Sí, se dio. Sí, se dio. Yo el año pasado yo toqué con en la banda donde yo toco, que es Pablo Menéndez. Pablo Menéndez Mezcla, que yo pertenezco a la banda de Pablo Menéndez, y tocamos en el Festival de Jazz porque fue en febrero. Fue justo antes de la pandemia, fue un festival bravo, bravísimo.
He said the festival did take place. It was in February, just before the pandemic hit, and he played with Pablo Menéndez band. And he said that it was a fierce concert. Pero la otra pregunta era que si tú crees que ya en este año o el año siguiente se va a dar el festival ese de nuevo, y si tú piensas que vas a tocar.
Y este año. Este año, ahora también en febrero, participamos, se hizo el Festival de Jazz, el 21, donde participamos online. Se hizo online, donde yo también estuve también con la misma banda, con Pablo Menéndez Mezcla. Estuvo varios grupos de la vanguardia del jazz actual cubano, el movimiento del jazz actual. Y se hizo virtual, se está haciendo virtual.
So this year it did happen. It did happen virtually, and he played with the same band, Pablo Menéndez band, and it was like all the vanguard of the jazz scene in Cuba was present. It was done, but it was done virtually.
Oh, okay. All right. I didn't realize. I missed it. I should have been there. God.
Se le pasó. Hubiese sabido.
Well, we're almost at our time. It's been so fascinating. The concert was amazing. I really want to thank Julio and his family, his band. It was just amazing.
Amazing. Thank you. Thank you, Yvonne. Thank you.
Yes.
The Valley. Thank you, Joshua, Ben, everyone. They are connected. Thank you very much. I feel so happy.
Yes, I want to go ahead and thank our sponsors again. Hawks, it's a presentation, Valley Jazz Informances, and Ben Golsher and Stephen Golsher from Hawks and Reed, Ginger Goldberry, John and Pat Kandursky, Arlene Avakian, Sherry Taylor, and Terry Lynn Carrington. I want to really thank Joshua. What a great job. I love my team. Oh my God, my team is amazing. Special thanks to Raquel Obregón, Kari Njiri, Eugene Uman, and the folks at Vermont Jazz Center, Paul Arsalanian, and any of my friends who helped promote this event tonight, and especially those who came. Thank you so much to the audience. I mean, I felt the energy. Everyone was having a great time. Julio, your music is amazing.
Amazing.
I couldn't stop listening. It was just so wonderful. And I'm so happy. This is the first time. It's not the last time. We'll be doing some more stuff here. So, you know, we're going to keep in touch. We're going to try and get some more concerts for you here in the U.S. Okay, Tavyang?
Está bien.
Yes.
Está bien.
Yes.
We're still online.
Yes, we're finishing up. But thank you everyone for coming. Take a look. Keep in touch. I send emails out, and there are ways. Go through Hawks and Reed if you want to join the mailing list and learn more about some collaborations that we'll be doing in the fall. So thank you very much, and good night, everyone.
Hasta luego.
Hasta luego, hasta luego, hasta luego.
Hasta luego.